Well, indeed, Jen, and it is great news all the way around, and another first for the Pease legacy. Pease was the first Air Force base to close, and then the first to show that you could successfully integrate the Air Force, the National Guard, and the community, and tonight, the first in the nation to be home to the KC-46.
Well, we were absolutely just exuberant and almost giddy.
The commanders of the New Hampshire Air National Guard and the 157th Air Refueling Wing are duly proud that Pease is the Air Force's first choice for their new refueling operation.
And it really solidifies our position here in the Seacoast as being a major player in the defense of our country for the long term, for 25 to 50 years out.
Pease has been home to 8 KC-135s and countless refueling missions. It will get 12 of the new KC-46s, bigger but less noisy, more efficient and environmentally friendly. They'll carry more cargo and create about 100 new jobs.
We expect around $40 million worth of military construction projects. And so it's a great jobs generator, both in the short run and in the long run.
This was just a great effort on the part of the Air National Guard, on the part of all of the active duty folks who are serving at Pease.
They have responded to every single conflict that we have been involved in. They have a wonderful duty relationship with the active duty that is unique and terrific in terms of what Pease is doing. And also they have superior infrastructure there, and we have a great strategic location.
It's going to be great for our economy, and it's just a great reflection of how skilled and expert our National Guard is.
Well, the Air Force will begin an environmental impact study, and if that goes well, the official announcement will be made next spring, and those airplanes, well, they'll start arriving in about 2018. Reporting live from the Seacoast Bureau in Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.